Hello, my name is Ganzonomy. I'm back again. As you can see, I have the Canon 24-105 F4 L IS USM lens in front of me. Today, we're going to demonstrate how to put onto your camera a filter. Now, a filter is a sort of glass designed to accentuate things that you may want, such as the sky, or remove haze or infrared interference. And on a digital camera, they are particularly important because CMOS sensors are not as in tune with taking away infrared, that is, not as in tune to not reacting to infrared. So they do react quite poorly to infrared. So the best filters for a digital camera have a infrared and a ultraviolet filter in one, so that you don't have to stack filters. The less you have to stack, the better off you are. So what I bought was a B+W UV IR cut filter, and this filter, as you can see shortly, is a very nicely made German filter made from shot glass, as we can see back here. It's made by Schneider Optical Works in Germany. Very high quality, recommended. Either them or Heliopan are my two preferences for filters. Even though it was a bit steep at $150, their glass is far superior, in my opinion, to anything made by Tiffin, Hoya, and so forth. So first we unbox the filter by opening it. Obviously, this is the filter. Has a nice bluish tinge to it. When we open it, has a nice reddish pinkish tinge as well. The multi-resistant coatings that are on this filter allow the glass to be harder than usual. So now we take our 24-105 and we remove the cap. Nice glass, isn't it? You take the filter and you turn it so that the side with the screws is facing towards the body of the lens, like so. You want to line them up as best as you can. Where in my case, they don't seem to want to line up. They did before. And you slowly screw the filter onto the lens, like so. It may take a little practice because this is a fairly large filter. It's a 77 millimeter. But eventually, it will go on. And now you have a filter on your camera. Now, you can stack filters, but stacking them, if you have a wide-angle lens, such as this is a 24-105, the more you stack, the greater the risk of what's called vignetting. Vignetting means that you'll have dark corners in your pictures. It's not exactly desirable. But on a 24 is really the limit for a normal width filter. After that, you get slim filters. They have special caps for them. But since this goes on my T2i, which I'm recording on, I can get away with a regular filter because of the 1.6 crop makes it effectively a 38 millimeter lens. That's pretty much it. If you like it, let me know. If you have any comments, feedback on my videos, let me know. If you tell your friends, tell your friends. If you have a response, let me know. And yes, I know there's a piece of dirt on that filter inside, so I'll fix that as soon as I finish the video. This is Ganzonomy, teaching you how to put filters onto your lenses. Have a good evening.